Parineeti, welcome, welcome. It's such a pleasure to have you around.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Hi, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Is it on? Hello?
Yep. Hi, guys. Hi, hi, hi. Good evening, good evening, good evening. It is so nice to be here. Good? This good?
Can I use this?
Yep. Thank you so, so much, first of all, for having me. I've been hearing about, this for years, and I hear about these expos, and I always used to wonder what they were about, but we never had the chance to really have them in our own country, let alone our own city. So I'm really happy you all are here. I can't wait to walk around and do a little bit of shopping. But before that, we'll speak a lot about my love and your love, which is diving. I'm really excited.
Just to know, since when have you been diving?
I actually had to shoot an underwater sequence for my film Kill Dil. And my diving guru, who is Anis Aidenwala, he's not here. His wife is here somewhere, Charmeen. She's here. There she is. So they are actually the reason I started to dive. They taught me in Mumbai, and then they took me all around the world. They arrange all my diving trips. So it's because of them that I really dive. But I started in 2013? 14. 2014 is when I started. So 5 years. So I'm a baby. new baby.
Well, I'm sure many like me may be present over there. Just to know, what do you like in particular about the sport?
What I like the most about diving? No phone network underwater. Nobody can call me. My manager cannot call me and tell me any work. Honestly, I used to hear a lot of these scuba divers who used to say, you know, it's like meditation. Some people say, you know, it's as good as a drug. Some people say, you know, it's the most peaceful thing. It always used to be theory for me. Sure. And then I remember my first time that I ever did a dive was in Bali. And I think that when I came out from my first dive, I think I was a changed person. I'm not a very sporty person. This was literally the only sport which was in my life. And I got addicted very quickly. And now I try at least to take 2 or 3 diving trips every year. And it's something that I cannot live without anymore.
I sum it up like a detox program for you.
I mean, it really is. Honestly, it is a detox program because I actually leave my phone behind. I've done land-based diving. I've done liveaboard diving. And I literally love to just forget about my phone. You know, that's the main thing. And I've made so many friends all over the world, you know, people who were on the boats with me or my instructors or the resorts that I've stayed in or, you know, the liveaboards. We meet so many new people. Wow. So I've made so many like friends all over the world now. So it's amazing.
When you say all around the world, where all around the world would you be diving?
I think I would say some of my favorites have been Sipadan. I loved Sipadan. Okay. I went there with Charmeen and Anis, of course. I love the Maldives. It's one of my favorites because it's just so easy to get to.
Superb.
Yeah, I love the Maldives. I did my liveaboard also at Maldives, actually. I did the Great Barrier Reef in Australia, of course. Unfortunately, we must do something to make it better, but at least I can say I've dived there. What else?
Where else?
I've forgotten. Charmeen. Oh, Palau, of course. How can I forget? I love, love, love Palau. Very exotic. Very few people get to actually go there in their lifetime. I've gone there twice because I loved it so, so much. So some of my favorites.
Any anecdotes on your diving experience? Any one in specific that would just cross your mind?
I think the experience that has stayed with me the most has been when I was in the Maldives with the whale sharks. Mm-hmm. And I think that was one of my favorite thing. And I also did a dive where I was at the cleaning station and I was with 14 mantas for 70 minutes. Whoa. And it was my first nitrox dive. So I did a really long dive. And even at the safety stop, I was just like surrounded by mantas. So I can never forget that experience.